I have Lory, Shem and Moti Leybel here, who are going to explain why we're out in the middle of the night again. So go okay. For it.
So this is Lory Shemtov. Lory kind of lost her kids 6 years ago to the welfare. The welfare actually came one day and just took the kids from her, gave them to her ex-husband with absolutely no reason. They just started to press four charges against her. And during the years she had a big struggle against them. She's well known as the woman that is struggling the welfare in Israel.
The last thing that happened is that
a judge, she even got to the Supreme Court, and the Supreme Court actually said that go for a psychiatric evaluation, and what's going on in there, this is what the decision will be. And they fined her for 10,000 shekels for it.
Which is about £2,000 in English money.
Yeah, so anyway... she had for 6 months, this woman that we're visiting, the social worker, is a main social worker. She sent her to do a psychiatric evaluation and told her that after she will get it and everything will be okay, she will get to see the kids again. But she got past the evaluation, everything was great, and the psychiatrist said that Lory is a capable mother and she can see the kids and everything, and Lory took it to court, family court. The family court judge is for a few years, he doesn't want to resign from the case, he wants to stay there because he's giving all the power to the back to the social worker. Now the social worker on her behalf, she saw the psychiatrist's evaluation, and actually she got so mad that Lory got a good evaluation that they fired the psychiatrist from the case. Now Lory has a great evaluation. She needs to see the kids by every court in Israel, and this social worker is actually preventing her from seeing her kids right now. 6 years she haven't seen the kids.
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
Because you're a blogger, Lory's a blogger, and yes, you're telling the truth. I know that you've both been taken many times, and your freedom of speech is hurt.
Yeah.
Do you think that because you're telling the truth, this is one of the reasons that she's been punished?
Absolutely.
Because she's telling the truth. She's
punished 100% for only saying the truth about what's going on here in the welfare and in the court of justice.
So people outside need to know that the Israeli people are really struggling to get the truth out, and they can't.
Yeah, they can't. We cannot. Once you try to get the truth out, they start to put you false in the police and courts.
Okay, so we can expect the police tonight, can we?
We are absolutely expecting the police.
Shouldn't take long.
The police, because we're not going to leave here so fast.
Okay, we'll roll on. Okay, thanks.
Thank you very much.
We have the police. Yeah, it was a matter of time. It's quite a quiet area, so it took a few minutes. But here they come.
As usual.
Police just came and they're just mumbling all this bullshit law. They're inventing laws during our conversation. I'm trying to explain to the police what I can and what I cannot do by the law, and they're trying to invent law such as it's disturbing my ears. I have selective hearing, and as long as it disturbs my ear, you're not allowed to do that. But I know that by the law, you have to have, you can shout up to maximum of 110
decibels.
Exactly. But apparently, the police officers in Israel does not know the law.
So they can't stop you.
They cannot stop me.
So
they can try to arrest me. They can try
to take
my megaphone.
Just for your information, there's another car.
It's not going to end good because they cannot do that.
They're here now.
Let them do that.
So we're just going to end this now. The police are so confused. The law was kept. Just the law was kept. They turned up security, police, you name it, absolutely everything, and there is nothing they can do. So the demonstration over. So I hope everybody outside Israel really enjoys seeing what freedom of speech looks like. Isn't it good fun?